There will be spoilers ahead for A Quiet Place. Hey, what's going on? How you doing? Today, I'm going to show you my top 10 favorite hidden details in A Quiet Place. So be very quiet. Because here we go. On Beau Abbott's grave, you can see he lived from the years 2016 through 2020. This movie starts on day 89 of the alien invasion, and after Beau's death, we jump forward to day 472. So a total of 383 days have passed since Beau's death, putting us more than a year after the space shuttle incident. Meaning A Quiet Place takes place in the year 2021, the year we're living in right now. On day 473 of the alien invasion, we get to see Evelyn's calendar. The day she writes on is October 3rd, 2021. And guess what? We're gonna do some more of that math. If we take the day October 3rd, 2021 and rewind 473 days, that will bring us to June 17th, 2020, about 2.5 weeks out from the 4th of July, possibly explaining why the Abbott family had fireworks on standby later in the film. On Lee's desk in the basement, you can see a notice from the Department of Defense. This haunting message had to be delivered on a piece of paper instead of a radio broadcast like it would normally be. Because you know that whole situation going on out there with the creatures? And speaking of newspapers hanging on the wall, on these newspapers you can see some of the headlines reading meteorite hits Mexico and meteors hit Denver. Other papers are calling it an alien invasion and counting 128 landing sites around the globe, confirming that the creatures are aliens from space and have landed here through a wave of meteorites. Any small noise will most likely set off the creatures. So the family walks on their bare feet, eats food without plates or silverware, uses Monopoly pieces made of fabric, and so on. Oh, and by the way, Regan totally cheats during Monopoly. She rolls an 8, but only moves forward 7 spaces to land on the collect your salary when you pass square. But thanks to Regan being deaf, the family had to know sign language before the alien invasion, which probably added to their chances of survival, so we'll let it slide. Where was I? Oh yeah. The family photos on the wall in the Abbott's house contain some of the real-life photographs of John Krasinski and Emily Blunt's family, as these two co-stars are actually married in real life. When Evelyn and Lee slow dance to the song Harvest Moon by Neil Young, they're using an early generation iPod that has no external speakers. So they won't run into that embarrassing moment where you accidentally disconnect your headphones and die. Harvest Moon is an interesting song choice because Evelyn's due date is the day before the Harvest Moon. Anytime the family is outside, they walk on these trails made of sand. During the opening title, we see a bunch of sand particles in the air before the text fades in. At the beginning of the film, when the Abbotts are in the grocery store, you can see that no one has touched a single bag of chips, also known as the loudest snack in the entire existence of humanity. Loud stuff like whipped cream and other sprays were left behind as well. When Evelyn is giving a math lesson to Marcus, she signs to him, "Remember, you need to divide," and then tells him, "Carry the 3," hinting at the end of the film where the family is divided and Evelyn is left alone to protect her 3 children. Lee is wearing this red sweater throughout the film, and in the end, Evelyn is wearing the same sweater, which signifies she is taking his place. That was my list of top 10 hidden details in A Quiet Place. Yeah, so let me know what your favorite detail was in the comments. I would actually like to know that. I feel like I'm forgetting something. Oh yeah, subscribe if you want to see more Quiet Place videos, because I will definitely be making more in anticipation of A Quiet Place 2. So thank you for watching, and hopefully I'll see you in my next A Quiet Place video.